Diageo is a global spirits company, the biggest spirits company within the world. Within Australia, we have multiple well-known brands like Bundaberg Rum, Smirnoff, Bailey's, Johnny Walker, Tanqueray.
So we have approximately 450 SKUs across our portfolio, of ranging from A-class to C-class SKUs. 80% of the sales of what we sell here in Australia is produced here locally at Huntingwood.
Yeah, local production is just shy of 10 million cases a year. So previously we had a more complicated network structure, I guess. We had a number of warehouses in Queensland, we had two warehouses in Sydney and one in WA. So what this has enabled us to do is to consolidate all our warehousing down into three warehouses, and predominantly the two in Sydney into one warehouse. We get a number of savings obviously from consolidation of those two warehouses. This is now the major distribution point within Australia for all of our network. We believe that having our own in-house NDC will give us a lot of flexibility around lead times, urgent orders that our customers generally do request. Having that in-house, we can make that decision of cost versus lead time versus service a lot better than relying on somebody else. And having one site versus two sites and reducing the number of shuttles, I think the number's 2,500 trucks off the road a year by not doing that shuttle leg, and that's a great win for our company and environmental targets that we aim for as well.
So the business case was signed off in July 2013, and then we went into demolition in January of the next year, 2014.
So during the 14 months of actual construction, when we tore down the old building, we're operating in a very confined space.
The congestion of vehicles on site, construction teams on site, etc., did pose a bit of a challenge. Being an operating site, so the production side of the facility didn't actually stop running during that period of time, but throughout that whole period we worked really well together.
Luckily we had a good partner, Bev Chain really helped us out in terms of running our Erskine Park facility and being flexible there, but also the staff went over and above around making sure that we could operate safely downstairs in that tough environment, but also manage our costs during that time.
Yeah, I think Dematic, right from the forefront, said it was going to be a challenge with the tight time frames that we put in. But I think what came out of the project was the consistency, the tenacity of the Dematic team that helped build what we see today, and the effort that went into that was outstanding.
To optimise the height of the building, Dematic selected a open face rack design. What that means is that we have no beams within the pallets, so the pallets are actually being held up by pallet runners. And over the design of the racking, that means we can fit more pallets vertically within any given space.
Why did we embark on it? Cost is an important factor. In terms of consolidating your stock into one place, that gives good service advantage. One of the number one measure for Diageo is around service to our customers. And we think we'll improve service by between 3 and 5% by consolidating that stock within one warehouse.
So the old DC before we demolished it was a 10,000 pallet warehouse. With the introduction of the Dematic High Bay warehouse, we've gone from 10,000 to 26,000 pallets.
One of the implementation challenges is the in-rack sprinkler systems. These systems are effectively integrated within the actual racking and need to be integrated and worked within the actual construction process. So the Dematic project team came up with a principle where we broke the six-aisle warehouse into two lots of three aisles, and by working through that in that fashion and effectively like zigzagging through the warehouse, we're able to then deliver the racking in the timeline that was required.
One of the mantras, I guess, for this project was touch it once. The more times you pick up a pallet, the more times you drop it off, the more times you put it on a truck, the more chance you've got of doing some damage.
Some of the times we were touching it between 4 and 8 times before it would get to the customer.
So we have a production facility on site. What we produce on site will be stored into the high bay warehouse and then be dispatched out to customers.
So by eliminating that process and just having one consolidated warehouse, we're able to take a number of touches and actually transport movements within Diageo's supply chain, and that's enabled them to have a far more efficient operation. Along with the supply is the IT system that Dematic provides, which is our warehouse control system. And that effectively interfaces to the paperless warehouse management system and also coordinates all of the real-time missions for both pallet movement and also for the crane movement.
The major advantage of this project is going to be when we come to our peak period. So during October, November, December, we can have a plant running 24/6 basically. Our staff right throughout this process have been amazing. They love the investment we're making in Australia, and to have a $20 million or $21 million investment on site has really been a shot in the arm of confidence that we've got in our local industry.
I think that's probably one of my proudest moments, is that having a warehouse crew that have been engaged from day one and taken the ownership of the actual project and wanting to drive the right business outcomes is something that I've not seen in the industry.
I thought that they'd start to tire after 6 months, but I've been absolutely amazed by particularly our warehouse staff, how they've stayed committed to this project for the last 14 months. And even today, as they learn new ways of doing things, they really had a positive attitude, and that's been a main success in the project.
We've gone live around 2 weeks ago, and we're still settling down our processes, etc. Dematic and paperless warehousing have worked really well with us to ensure that that bedding down process is happening as quickly as possible.
So we sell to around about 120 customers here in Australia.
The good news so far is that our customers haven't noticed the difference. During the 14 months of the project, we kept in regular communication with all of our major customers to tell them what was going on in case they experienced issues. The good news was that during that time, they really didn't experience issues. Once we actually have all our product in one spot, which will be from next week at the beginning of April, that's when they'll really start to see that benefit of consolidation of our products and that flexibility that I've talked about, how that will start to translate into better service levels to the likes of Coles, Woolworths and ALM.